Now what actually is wave? Okay, so what I taught you, see, this is assertion reason question for NEET, that when the cork travels, supposing this is a wave, right? The wave, what
Yes.
do we actually see? What in the wave, what we are actually seeing, that wave nature is again due to the cork is actually moving up and down in its own place. Here, there is a transfer of the, you can say the water is moving. So the kinetic energy of water, this is making the cork move up and down at the same position. So matter does not travel. It is the energy which is moving, the kinetic energy of the wave which is actually moving the object up and down. So matter does not change. It is the energy which changes. Okay, now we'll see what are the important features which actually a wave is characterized by, or you can say characteristic of wave. First is most important, that is the wavelength. And that wavelength is denoted by lambda. So what is wavelength, right? It is defined as the distance between two nearest crests or nearest trough. Now this you are studying, you study in the physics also, and it is measured in angstrom, angstrom or picometer or nanometer or centimeter and meter. So in any of these units you can measure it. So 1 angstrom is equal to how much?
One angstrom is in raised to minus 15. Well,
Yes, tell me.
10 raised to -15.
Ten raised to
-15, right? With -12.
And if you talk about 1 picometer, 10 raised to -12. 10. 1 picometer is equal to 10 raised to -12.
Okay.
1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to -9, and 1 centimeter is equal to 10 raised to -2. Yes, tell me. Written?
Yeah, sir.
Okay. Now we'll see the next. That is the frequency. Now, can you tell me what is frequency?
Frequency is the amount of times a certain motion is happening, or in this case, the amount of crests or troughs.
Yeah, so you can add on frequency of a wave is a number of waves which pass through a point in 1 second, and it is measured in hertz, or it is measured in per second or cycle per second. Now you may be having notes in Akash. You will be getting this also, CPS. They give this also, CPS. So how will you convert? We can say that 1 hertz is equal to 1 per second is equal to 1 CPS.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I'm putting you one question that the frequency of, write down, this is the AIPMT question. The frequency of an electromagnetic radiation is 2 into 10 raised to 6 hertz. What is the in meters? You can 6.0 into 10 raised to 14, 1.5 into 10 raised to 14 into, sorry, 4. It is 4, huh? 4. 1.5 into 10 raised to 2 and 0.66 into 10 raised to minus 2. Really? Yes.
Yes, sir, I'm calculating.
Okay.
Temperature.
Yeah, what is, yeah, what
Will
is
it
the
be the
answer?
third option? 1.5 times 10 raised to 2. The third option. Third
How?
option.
How? You have calculated perfectly.
Yeah. So basically, it will be the speed of light upon 2 raised to 10, 2 times 10 raised to 6, right?
Yes.
Okay. So it will be 3 times 10 raised to 8 upon 2 times 10 raised to 6. So it will become 10 raised to 2, and 3 upon 2 will become 1.5. So 1.5 times 10 raised.
Chalo, next we'll see about the time period. Do you know something about time period? I want to go a bit fast. Now, time period is
Okay.
T. Time taken for one complete oscillation of wave is known as period. Time taken by wave to travel a distance equal to one wavelength. So if C is speed of wave, then C is equal to lambda by T. Okay, so amplitude is related to what?
In?
Written?
No, I'm still writing. Yeah, it's done.
Okay. Now, next is wave number. That is nu bar. Number of wavelengths. Per unit length. So nu bar is equal to 1 upon lambda. And fifth is amplitude, that is A. So it is the height of depth or crest of a trough of a wave. So, or you can say depth or you can say crest, not right, or trough of a wave. Okay, see, basically we studied yesterday na, so crest and trough, the height and depth. Done.
Yes.
Okay. Now next is velocity. Now, what is velocity? It is defined as the distance covered by a wave in 1 second. So V is equal to C upon lambda. So, do one thing, write down the topic concept. I'll be giving you some concepts in between, okay? So that concepts is related to this. It is not exactly from this, but we will try to understand what exactly this is, because these are also the questions that are being put up, right? Chalo, should I
Yes.
rub?
Oh, one
Yeah.
second, one second.
Okay.
Yeah, it's done.
Yeah, so write down the concept. The concept is, it is regarding the amplitude. Okay, the amplitude of a wave. Yeah, the amplitude of a wave is related to the amount of energy it carries. Okay, how much amount of energy it is carrying, and the sound is perceived as louder. If the amplitude increases and softer, if the amplitude decreases. Can you explain me this? Explain me this.
It's basically, the level of sound is based on the amplitude and it's increasing and decreasing. Such as if the amplitude of a sound increases, the sound becomes louder. For example, the jet engines, when their energy increases, the sound of the jet engines also gets louder. And when it softens it, and the sound softens if the amplitude decreases. For example, an engine stopping suddenly. Like the amplitude of the sound has gotten lower, so the sound has softened out.
Yes. Now next is near infrared waves are used in remote controls, and far infrared waves. They are what? Radiant heat. And gamma rays have the greatest energy. Yes, written.
On gamma rays.
In.
Oh, 1 second.
Ah, fine. Well.
Yes, it's done.
Okay. So now can you tell me, do you have any idea of electromagnetic waves?
Magnetic waves are generated when electricity passes through a metal object. These electromagnetic waves are what help to form electromagnets.
Yeah. See, basically, what do we see that in the case of electromagnetic waves? See, electromagnetic waves, they contain both. Electromagnetic waves, actually, it contains both electric and magnetic field, and this energy is always transferred. In the form of waves, with speed of light, 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. And we can say that it's a pure energy wave. Yes. Clear up.
1 second, in the last 5. Yeah, disorder.
It does not contain mass. And no medium is required. For transmission. Next, direction of propagation. Yes. From both. Electric and magnetic field. So there are various types of electromagnetic waves. You can see the radiation, which differs from one another in wavelengths. For example, cosmic rays, gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible rays, infrared radiation, infrared waves, microwaves, and radio waves.
One second, I just checked.
Yeah.
Yeah, disorder.
Now we'll see that now in I have to share you some. I'm sharing some diagram. Okay, draw this diagram. I have shared to ma'am, she will share it to you.
Okay.
Neil, I have sent it in the group.
Okay, I got the image. Yeah, sir, I got the image. भाई या मामा,
ओके, कैन यू एक्सप्लेन मी दिस?
एक्सप्लेन व्हाट?
The diagram which you have drawn, what does it show?
Diagram that I have drawn, it shows it basically shows the
There are three dimensions.
magnetic field is proportional to the electric field, and it is continuous along a certain length on the direction.
Is it proportional or is it making some angle?
It is making a 90-degree angle.
Yeah, very good. Okay. Making an angle of 90 degree with the
With the K vector, that is a propagation direction.
very good. So write down this theory below this. The above diagram explains
Yes.
down the electric wave and the electric field and the magnetic field. Both of them are perpendicular to each other in the direction of propagation of wave. Write down. Now I am giving you some further notes. Write down first. Gracias. Done.
Done, done.
Okay, that is the electromagnetic wave. Now here I have presented you a question. Now tell me the answer.
Maybe max lambda will be in radio waves, right?
Why?
Because it is of highest intensity out of all of these. It is the one which has the highest intensity out of ultraviolet radio waves, X-rays, and infrared waves. Radio waves have the highest. No, wait. It will be X-rays. Sorry, X-rays has the highest intensity.
Okay. Fine. Now, can you explain me whatever you have understood about electromagnetic variations?
About electromagnetic waves, I know. First of all, it is that energy is always transferred in the form of electromagnetic waves. Then, after that, it is pure energy waves. These waves are always transmitted at the speed of light, that is 3 times 10^8 meters per second. Then
then
examples are the cosmic rays, G rays, X rays, radio waves, microwaves, visible rays, UV rays, IR rays, etc. And there are
Yes.
various types of electromagnetic waves, which are differ in intensity. Then I drew that one diagram which you had sent to ma'am and then sent to me.
Fine.
Electromagnetic is derived from electric and magnetic field, those two words. That's it.
Okay. Now, what is the limitation of Maxwell theory of electromagnetic waves? See, first we will see the phenomenon of BBR. BBR is black body radiation. Okay. Second is photoelectric effect, and third is line spectra of atoms. So these three we will now see, because you know these three basically deals with the ejection of electrons. Okay, again I will share you a very beautiful pic of entire electromagnetic radiation. It is a huge pic. It will take you a lot of time. So you draw it after the class. Okay. What time will you go to, Akash?
Yeah, leave from here at 10:15, 10:30. It's there by 11.
Okay, 10:15. 10:15 to 4.
Yes, teacher.
Now write down next. When light coming from a source is scattered, by a prism, light of different wavelengths are deviated through different angles. And they get separated. This phenomena is known as dispersion, and such a dispersed light And such a dispersed light may be received by received by or received on a photographic plate or it can be observed or it can be viewed by eye. A collection of dispersed light. Giving its wavelength. Giving its wavelength composition is called spectrum. Right. Oh.
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay. So, you know what is spectrum? Spectrum, it is a band of colors. Okay. There are different band of colors. And each supposing, now see, supposing sodium metal is there. Now, what is the color of sodium metal? What color light sodium metal emits?
White light, right?
Huh?
No, sir, I don't.
Okay. Understand this way. Supposing any element is there and it is emitting light. Now, supposing the specificity like copper emits blue color. Okay. So now when I will strike a light. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Band will be there. What is the band? Band will be violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. So in this case of where it should be blue, there will be totally a dark line. Are you getting?
Getting
All
up, getting up.
the color lines will be there, only this blue line will be dead. Why? Because this blue line is the color which is absorbed by this specific element. According to physics, why the leaves are green in color? Because the leaf absorb all the color except green, but according to biology, green chlorophyll is present, because of that it is green.
Okay.
But according to physics, it is green. Why? Because it is absorbing, means it is reflecting the green part. That is why it is green in color.
Yes,
Why is
understood.
color? Why grass is green? Why roses are red? Are you getting? So, physics says this blue color is
Understood.
already emitted. Yeah. So, it has already been radiated. So, therefore, there is no space. Therefore, this line will be not visualized under the spectrum. Are you getting? So, on the basis
Getting
of this, you will get questions. Yeah. So this is concept which you really need to understand. If you understand the concept, then you know it becomes easy for you to do the questions also, ki why I cannot see because of this reason, so we have to solve. So many children, they lose out with this concept, and therefore they make mistakes in solving the questions also.
Yes. Oh.
So we can say that what is spectrum? You can explain me. What
The
is a
spectrum
spectrum?
is basically the collection of dispersed light, which gives its own wavelength composition.
Yes. So when white light, define the word spectrum.
So when white light coming from a source is scattered by the prism, by a prism, scattered by a prism, gives light of different lambdas or wavelengths. These lights are deviated through different angles and get separated. When they are separated, they form seven colors. These seven colors together are known as a spectrum of colors.
Yes, that is known as the spectrum. Okay. So I hope you have understood and you are not confused with this topic.
No, I'm not confused.
Okay, fine. So we'll continue with the types of spectrum, and I'm sharing you two beautiful diagrams. You please draw it, okay? Just now. Means whenever you want, I'm sharing it to ma'am. Okay? Bye. Bye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye.
Rohan, move to room 2. Sir is in
Okay.
room 2.
Okay.